Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our show. My name is Claire Bloom. I'm the executive director here at the Tarzana Community and Cultural Center. I have the great honor of presenting tonight a tribute to Burt Bacharach and Hal David, one of the greatest songwriting teams of all time. I'm especially excited about tonight's show because I grew up in the 70s, which was a wonderful time, in my opinion, the most wonderful time for pop. I love listening to many of the songs that you're going to hear tonight on the radio while I was growing up, recorded by such greats as Dionne Warwick, The Carpenters, B.J. Thomas, The Fifth Dimension, and others. Our show tonight is produced by our good friend, the incredibly talented Jay Asher. We want to thank Jay for generously donating all the proceeds to this show to the Community and Cultural Center. This has been a difficult year for us, as I know it has been for many of you and businesses and organizations all over. We are very, very grateful for our relationship with Jay and for his generous gift of the fabulous program that you're about to see. One last thing, I have to get a plug for my own show here at the center. You can also see Jay perform in a couple of weeks at another music show that we do here on a monthly basis, our Tarzana Music Nights Live. Tickets to this show are just $5, and it features professional and semi-professional songwriters, singer-songwriters from the LA area. Tickets can be purchased on our website at www.mytarzana.org. And again, they're just $5. It's an incredible bargain. These are really great shows featuring some of the best local talent in Los Angeles. If you go to our website, you can also sign up for our newsletter and you will get emails that tell you about all the great entertainment and cultural events that we've been having even throughout the pandemic. We've been doing a lot of things through Zoom, comedy shows, music shows, and wonderful concerts like the one that you're about to see this evening. Lastly, I want to give a big shout out to Gary Johns, who is our audio engineer extraordinaire, and he's handling all the sound and recording for the show. He's not just a great audio engineer and technician, he's also the president of the board of directors. And without his skills and expertise, we simply would not be able to put on these kinds of shows. So thank you, Gary, the man behind the wall of sound. Now, without further ado, please welcome Mr. Jay Asher and his fabulous guests, Paula Sargent and Kelly Huff.
Magic moments, memories we been sharing, magic moments when two hearts are caring. I'll never forget the moment we kissed, the night of the hayride, the way that we hugged to try to keep warm while taking a sleigh ride. Magic moments, memories we've been sharing. Magic moments when two hearts are caring. Time can't erase the memory of these magic moments filled with the telephone calls that tied up the line for hours and hours. The Saturday dance, I got up the nerve to send you some flowers. Magic moments, memories we've been sharing. Magic moments, when two hearts are caring. Time can't erase the memory of these magic moments filled with The way that we cheered whenever our team was scoring a touchdown. The night that the floor fell out of my car when I put the clutch down. The penny arcade, the games that we played, the fun and the prizes. The Halloween hop where everyone came in funny disguises. Magic moments filled with love. Thank you. Tonight, we're doing songs by the songwriting team of Burt Bacharach and Hal David, with one exception, one lyric by Bob Hilliard. Burt and Hal wrote together. Their first big hits were in 1958. The first one was The Story of My Life by Marty Robbins, and then this one by Perry Como, Magic Moments. And it was a big hit. Burt continued to write with others, and so did Hal for a few years. And eventually, I think it was probably right around 1962, Eunice David, who was out there, Hal's wife, would know for sure, but I'm pretty sure it's around 62, they decided to form an exclusive partnership. I had heard a number of their songs, but I wasn't really aware of them as a team until I bought an album by my favorite singer of the era, Gene Pitney, called Only Love Can Break a Heart. And it had Only Love Can Break a Heart. The whole album was produced by Burt and Hal. And it had, it also had True Love Never Runs Smooth and The Man Who Shot Liberty Valance. And then after that, I became aware that a whole lot of songs I knew and loved, like Gene McDaniel's Tower of Strength. Remember that? If I were a tower of strength, I'd watch you crawl. I'd laugh at your tears and tell you goodbye. I don't want you. And so I became aware of a number of songs. And then, of course, Dionne Warwick had all these hits and Gene. This is one that they actually wrote, and they had Pitney in mind, and he didn't want to do this one. So Billy J. Kramer and the Dakotas and a few other people, and of course, Dionne Warwick did it as well. Trains and boats and planes are passing by. They mean a trip to Paris or Rome for someone else, but not for me. The trains and the boats and planes took you away, away from me. We were so in love and high above. We had a star to wish upon wish and dreams come true, but not for me. The trains and the boats and planes took you away, away from me. You are from another part of the world. You had to go back a while, and then you said you soon would return again. I'm waiting here like I promised to. I'm waiting here, but where are you? Trains and boats and planes took you away, but every time I see them I pray. And if my prayers can cross the sea, the trains and the boats and planes will bring you back, back home to me. I promise to, I'm waiting here. Bubba, where are you? Trains and boats and planes took you away, but every time I see them, I pray. And if my prayers can cross the sea, the trains and the boats and planes will bring you back, back home to me. Thank you. Here's one of Pitney's biggest hits with Bert and Hal. Gene was an unusual talent. He was dubbed the Prince of Pain because even when he sang a happy song, he sounded like he was suffering. And I loved Gene Pitney, and I still do. Dearest darling, I had to write to say that I won't be home anymore, 'cause something happened to me while I was driving home, and I'm not the same anymore. Oh, I was only 24 hours from Tulsa. I was only one day away from your arms. I saw a welcoming light and stopped to rest for the night, and that is when I saw her as I pulled in front of the small motel. She was there, and so I walked up to her, asked where I could get something to eat, and she showed me where. Oh, I was only 24 hours from Tulsa. I was only one day away from your arms. She took me to the cafe. I asked her if she would stay. She said, okay. I was only 24 hours from Tulsa. I was only one day away from your arms. The jukebox started to play, and nighttime turned into day as we were dancing closely. All of a sudden, I lost control and died. Held her charms, and I caressed her, kissed her, told her I'd die before I would let her out of my arms. Oh, I was only 24 hours from Tulsa. I was only one day away from your arms. I hate to do this to you, but I love somebody new. What can I do when I can never, never, never go home again? Thank you. This next song was a big hit for Bobby Vinton, for those of you who remember Bobby. Bobby had a huge hit with Roses Are Red, My Love, had a couple of other hits, and then he was having a little trouble getting chart records again. Bobby had started as a trumpet player and a band leader, and he prided himself on being a tough businessman.
Now, this was an era when the songwriters would go and go to an artist's office or a producer's office and play the songs for them. And Bert brought this to him. I've heard two different tales, Eunice. One is that Hal was with him and one that he wasn't. So I'm not sure which. You'll let me know at some point, maybe. But at any rate, the song was played for Bobby, and Bobby is listening, and he's thinking, oh, my God, this is a hit. But when Bert's finished singing it for him, he says, well, he says, it's a nice song. I see it more as an album cut than I see it as a hit single. So I'll do it, but I'd have to get half the publishing royalties. And Bert packs, puts the music back in his briefcase, starts to walk down the hall. Bobby goes running at him, says, Bert, I was only kidding. It's a great song. I was only kidding. And it was a big hit for Bobby. It got to be, I believe, number 4 on the charts. So he made the right call. But tells you something about Bobby Vinton.
Blue on blue, heartache on heartache. Blue on blue, now that we got through. Blue on blue, heartache on heartache. And I find I can't get over losing you. I walk along the street we used to walk. 2 by 2 lovers pass. And as they're passing by, I could die, 'cause you're not here with me. Now the trees are bare, there's sadness in the air, and I'm as blue as I can be. Blue on blue, heartache on heartache. Blue on blue, now that we got through. Blue on blue, heartache on heartache. And I find I can't get over losing you. Night after lonely night, we meet in dreams. As I run to your side, you wait with open arms that now are closed to me. Through a veil of tears, your vision disappears, and I'm as blue as I can be. Blue on blue, heartache on heartache. Blue on blue, now that we are through. Blue on blue, heartache on heartache. And I find I can't get over losing you. Blue on blue, heartache on heartache. Blue on blue, now that we are through. Blue on blue, heartache on heartache. And I find I can't get over losing you.
Kelly Huff. You'll hear more from Kelly later.
Just saying, man. Just saying.
Thank you. It is my pleasure to introduce to you a woman who is the reason I came to L.A. I had the house band in the lounge at the Boston Playboy Club. This would have been 1970. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And they had a room upstairs where there would be different singers and comedians come in, some quite well known. And in came a singer named Brandy Perry. And that was Paul at the time. And I really loved the way she sang. And I was always pretty ambitious with my songs. And I had a couple of songs, very Bacharach David inspired, no doubt. And I played them for her. And she said, oh, I love them. If you'll do arrangements for me, I'll put them right in the act. And I did. And she said, I'm tired of being on the road. If I get a steady job in LA, would you come out and play for me? And I said, sure, happy to, thinking that's the end of that. And several months later, I got the call. She had a job and called me to come and play for her. And we've
been playing ever since.
Ever since, yeah. So this is Paula Sargent.
It is my pleasure, Mr. J. Here we go. The moment I wake up, before I put on my makeup, I say a little prayer for you. While combing my hair now, and wondering what dress to wear now, I say a little prayer for you. Forever and ever, you'll stay in my heart, and I will love you forever and ever. We never will part, and how I love you together, together. That's how it must be to live without you. It would only be heartbreak for me. For the bus, dear, while riding I think of us, dear, I say a little prayer for you. At work I just take time, and all through my coffee break time, I say a little prayer for you. Forever and ever, you'll stay in my heart, and I will love you forever and ever. We never will part, and how I love you together, together. That's how it must be to live without you. It would only be heartbreak for me. I love when you play. I say a little prayer for you. I say for you. Forever and ever, we'll stay in my heart, and I will love you forever and ever. We never will part, and how I love you together, together. That's how it must be to live without you. Would only be heartbreak for me. My darling, believe me, for me there is no one but you. Love me too. I'm in love with you. Answer my prayer. Say you love me too. I say a little prayer for you. I say a little prayer. I say a little prayer. Thank you.
Here's a little medley we put together of two terrific songs by Bert and Hal. One is The Look of Love that was recorded by 15 people, big hit at least twice. The other is the first of the Dionne Warwick tunes we're doing tonight, which is Walk On By.
The look of love is in your eyes, a look your smile can't disguise. The look of love is saying so much more than ever say, and what my heart has heard, it takes my breath away. I can hardly wait to hold you, feel my arms around you. How long I have waited, waited just to love you. Now that I have found you, you've got the look of love, it's on your face, a look that time can't erase. Be mine.
to hold you. Feel my arms around you. How long I have waited just to love you. Now that I have found you, don't ever go.
Walking down the street, and I start to cry each time we meet. Walk on by.
Walk on by.
Walk on by.
Walk on by. Is all that I have left. So let me hide. Tears, sadness you gave me when you said goodbye. Walk on.
Thank you. I may have put the, is that the wrong key?
Yeah. Okay.
Sorry about that.
Completely wrong. Okay.
Oh, okay.
It was for someone who sings higher.
Yeah. Okay. And now we come to the very sad tale of Lou Johnson. Lou was a wonderful singer, and Bert and Hal loved the way he sang. And they would go in and they would record a song with Lou, put out the record, and it would sink like the proverbial stone. And then they would do it with Dionne Warwick and it would go to the top of the charts. So poor Lou, some of the songs you're gonna be hearing now, just wanna point out that Lou originally did. Go through a day, and the things that people say, they make you feel so small. They make you feel like your heart will just never stop aching. So when you just can't accept the abuse you are taking, darling, reach out for me. Don't you worry, I'll see you through. You just have to reach out for me. I'll be there and I'll comfort you. Oh yes, I will comfort you and love you. How I'm gonna love you. When good friends prove untrue, the things they do to you, they make you feel so bad. They make you feel that you're having a reason for living. And when you feel you could throw in the towel and just give in, darling, reach out for me. Don't you worry, I'll see you through. You just have to reach out for me. I'll be there and I'll comfort you. Oh, yes, I will comfort you and love you. How I'm gonna love you. Reach out, for me. Yeah. Reach out, reach out for me, baby. Reach out, for me, yeah. Reach out for me. Poor Lou, I felt so bad for poor Lou. Here's a song that the head of Burt's label, A&M Records, Herb Alpert, who became his friend, asked Burt and Hal for a song for him to do. And he was a wonderful trumpet player, wasn't the greatest singer in the world. So they had to pick a song that wasn't as rangy and difficult to sing as many of the ones that they wrote. And apparently he did this in like about two takes. And everybody was happy with it. And this is probably one of my three or four favorites, and probably one of everybody's three or four favorites. You see this guy, this guy's in love with you. Yes, I'm in love. Who looks at you the way I do? When you smile, I can't tell we know each other very well. How can I show you? I'm glad got to know you, 'cause I've heard some talk. They say you think I'm fine. This guy's in love, and what I do to make you mine, tell me now, is it? So don't let me be the last to know. My hand a shaking, don't let my heart keep breaking, 'cause I need your love. I want your love. Play it, Herb. Now it is my privilege to present to you my old friend and wonderful singer, Kelly Huff. Kelly and I first met when I got hired to be the rehearsal piano player for the Doodletown Pipers.
Ouch.
They were kind of a big deal at that point. They had been on the Perry Como show and performed all over. They were kind of young American-ish, but a little more diverse, right?
Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
And, I'll buy that.
And Kelly was one of the Doodletown Pipers. And we didn't see each other for many years, and then we reconnected at a party from a friend of ours, the late Drew Daniels.
That's true.
And since then, we've been working together again, and he's one of my favorite people. This is the only song we are doing tonight that is not a Hal David lyric. This was by Bob Hilliard, who wrote a number of good songs with Bert.
And if you don't mind me, Mr. J, if I might give some credit to a gentleman that maybe not too many people will remember, but in this trade, in this business, he was a giant behind the scenes of choreography and understanding how to make entertainment work. His name was Ward Ellis, and he was the guy who put a whole lot of inspiration into me. So, and I know Mr. J remembers Ward. So hats off to you, my friend. Thank you for what you did for me. Just saying. Okay. All right. What do we got, Mr. J? I will hear you say goodbye, my love. Ooh, and you'll be on your way. Then the blue shadow will fall all over town. Yeah, any day now, I'll be all alone. Ooh, oh, oh, oh. Any day now, when your restless eye sees someone new, yeah, baby, to my sad surprise, then the blue shadow will fall all over town. Oh, Lord. Any day now, I'll be all alone. Whoa, whoa, whoa. You see, I know you never want to keep you if you don't want to stay. Yeah. Until you've gone forever, I'll keep holding on for dear life. This way, I'm begging you to stay. Well, any day now, when that clock strikes go, you'll call it off. Oh, baby, and then my tears will flow, and the blue shadow will fall all over time. Oh, Lord. Say any day now, I'll be all alone, 'cause you're not coming home. No. Oh, baby, sugar mama, don't fly away. Yeah. Don't fly away, don't fly away, don't fly away, yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, don't fly away. Thanks, you guys.
And here's one of my favorites that Kelly's going to sing for you. It's hard for me to give this one up, but he just sings it. He just sings it better.
A chair is still a chair, even when there's no one sitting there. Ooh. But a chair is not a house. A house is not a home when the two of us are far apart and one of us has a broken heart. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. A room is still a room, even when it's filled with gloom. Oh, but a room is still a house, and a house is not a home when the two of us are far apart and one of us has a broken heart. And now and then I call your name, and suddenly your face appears, but it's just a silly game, and when it ends, it ends in pain. Pretty little baby, have a heart. Don't let this one thing keep us apart. I was wrong, and I know it. I am not meant to live alone. Turn this house into a home. When I climb those stairs and turn that key, pretty mama still be there, still in love with me. Hey, hey, hey. Want you to be still in love with me. Baby.
Thank you. Kelly Huff. Wow. You got to give me credit. I got a lot of chutzpah to follow that guy, right? It's a song, actually a medley of two songs I've put together. Bert and Hal wrote a number of songs for the movies. This first song in the medley won the Academy Award for Best Song. Bert also won for Best Score. B.J. Thomas sang it. And then there was another movie where they did a kind of a similar song that B.J. also did. And I think that song doesn't get all the love it should, so I've put it together as a little medley for you.
Raindrops keep falling on my head, and just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit. Those raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling. So I just did me some talking to the sun, and And I said I didn't like the way he got things done, sleeping on the job. Those raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling. But there's one thing I know, the blues they send to meet me won't defeat me. It won't be long till happiness steps up to greet me. Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, 'cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because I'm free. Nothing's worrying me. Where have the people gone? Seems like there's no one hanging on. Look through the windows, the houses are empty. Hey, everybody's out of town. Seems like I'm the only one around. All of the streets are bare, no traffic tie-ups anywhere. Don't have to wait for a seat at the movies. Hey, everybody's out of town. Seems like I'm the only one around. Everyone's moved out from the ghetto. Lots of space, empty apartments, no more pollution, plenty of classrooms every place. And it looks like we're ready to give it one more try. This time there'll be no alibis. I'm gonna send out a message to Noah. Hey, better send some people down. Everyone on earth is out of town, and I'm the only one around. Everybody's out of town. Make it easy on yourself. Make it easy on yourself. 'Cause breaking up is so very hard to do. If you really love him, and there's nothing I can do. Don't try to spare my feelings, just tell me that we're through. And make it easy on yourself. Make it easy on yourself, 'cause breaking up is so very hard to do. And if the way I hold you can't compare to his caress, no words of consolation will make me miss you less. my darling, if this is goodbye, I just know I'm gonna cry. So run to him before you start crying too. And make it easy on yourself. Make it easy on yourself. 'Cause breaking up is so very hard to do. So very hard to do. It's so hard to do.
Thank you. So, Burton Bacharach and Hal David, only wrote one Broadway musical called Promises, Promises. It was a take on the movie The Apartment with Jack Lennon, and Neil Simon wrote the script, and Burton Hal wrote the songs. So, the show came into Boston first for a trial run, which was not unusual for shows that were going to Broadway. I actually saw it in Boston. And they decided that in the second act, that one of the songs they thought was going to be the big song was not quite working. And they needed a replacement, but there was only one problem. Bert came down with pneumonia and he was in the hospital. And the way the story came down to me, and once again, Eunice will tell me later if I was wrong, is that David Merrick, the producer of the show, who was a tough cookie, shall we say, came in and said, the song isn't working, we need a new song. And Bert said, I'm in the hospital. And David said, I don't care. We need a new song for the second act. And Hal wrote the lyric. They wheeled Bert into some adjacent room in a hotel or something where there was a piano. And supposedly he wrote the song to Hal's lyric very quickly. And of course it became the breakout hit song from the show. You'll see a reference to this in the lyric that Hal cleverly snuck in. What do you get when you fall in love? A girl with a pin to burst your bubble. That's what you get for all your trouble. I never fall in love again. I'll never fall in love again. What do you get when you kiss a girl? You get enough germs to catch pneumonia. After you do, she'll never phone ya. Never fall in love again. Don't you know that I'll never fall in love again? Don't tell me what it's all about. 'Cause I've been there and I'm glad I'm out. Out of those chains that bind you, that is why I'm here to remind you. What do you get when you give your heart? You get it all broken up and battered. That's what you get, a heart that's shattered. I never fall in love again. Don't you know that I never fall in love again? Oh, out of those chains that bind you, that is why I'm here to remind you. What do you get when you fall in love? You only get lies and pain and sorrow. So for at least until tomorrow, I never fall in love again. I never fall in love again. I never fall in love again. Like to bring Paula back on stage. Yeah. This is a song, and Bert always said that for him, the music and the arrangement were inseparable. He would hear them together, and if the arrangement wasn't right, he couldn't get the song right. This was one case where he admitted he just blew the arrangement. He just couldn't get it right. He did a truly dreadful version of this with Richard Chamberlain. I mean, it was really bad. So
Dr. Kildare?
Herb Alpert was looking for a song for a new group he had had called The Carpenters. And they had had a mild hit with a version of Ticket to Ride, but they were very talented. Karen had one of the great voices of all time. And Richard was a USC trained, you know, composer and arranger and pianist. You know, he was the real deal. He knew what he was doing. And they gave the arrangement to Richard, and Richard hit it out of the park. And of course, Karen sang it wonderfully. And now Paula's going to sing it for
you. Oh, boy. What a setup.
Why do birds suddenly appear every time you are near? Just like me, they long to be close to you. Why do stars fall down from the sky every time you walk by? Just like me, they long to be close to you. On the day that you were born, the angels got together and decided to create a dream come true. So they sprinkled food dust in your hair, a golden starlight in your eyes of blue. That is why all the girls in town follow you all around. Just like me, they long to be close to you.
Like the old days.
The day that you were born, the angels got together and decided to create a dream come true. So they sprinkled moon dust in your hair and golden starlight in your eyes of blue. That is why all the girls in town follow you. Oh, like me, they long to be close to you. Just like me, they long to be close to you.
Whoa.
Levine. Whoops. Paula Sargent. She's got so many names, I can't keep track of.
It's okay. I'll even answer to Brandy Perry from you.
Okay, Cal, you're
Thank
back.
You.
Here's another one that's been a hit a couple of times. It was a big hit for Dion, of course, after Lou struck out with it, as we have mentioned. And then later a group, I think, were they called Naked Eyes in the 80s, had a remake of it? Yeah.
Yeah. No.
I walk along the city streets you used to walk along with me. And every step recalls us how much in love we used to be. How can I forget you when there is always something there to remind me? Yeah, yeah, always something there to remind me. I was born to love you, and I will never be free. You'll always be a part of me. You see, when shadows fall, I pass a small cafe where we would dance at night. And I can't help recalling how it felt to kiss and hold you tight. How can I forget you now when there is always something there to remind me? Always something there to remind me. I was born to love you, and I will never be free. You'll always be a part of me. Whoa. Should ever miss the sweet and tender love we used to share. Just come back to the places that we used to go, and I'll be there. How can I forget you now? There is always something there to remind me. Always something there to remind me. I was born to love you, and I will never be free, because I see there's nothing there to remind me. Always something there to remind me. Oh, always something there to remind me.
Yeah, that would work.
Jay.
And now another Lou Johnson flameout. Poor Lou. Poor Lou.
You know.
Smash hit for Dion.
Right, right. He was like who was the guy for the Beatles, the drummer, before he said?
Pete Best.
Nah, I don't want Beatles. Nah.
The difference is Lou was good.
And Lou was good. And poor Pete is probably still saying, hey, would you like a shake with those fries? Anyway, poor guy. I love this song, and I'm going to sing it just like the guy who needed to hear it from the girl. Fly away to New Orleans. Kentucky bluebird, fly away and take this message to Michael. Message to Michael. Tell him I miss him more each day.
the plane pulled in down the bay. I feel Michael Devil be coming back. Woo! You see, it's a year since he was there. Kentucky bluebird fly away and take this message to Michael. Message to Michael. Tell him I miss him each day. But as his train pulled out down the track, oh, Michael promised he'd soon be coming back. Oh, don't think how my heart just breaks in two since we've been apart. And even though his dreams of fame fell through, to me he'll always be a star. Oh, fly away to New Orleans, Kentucky bluebird fly away and take this message to Michael. Message to Michael. Tell him to start for home today. If you find him, please won't you let him know, rich or poor, I will always love him so. Fly away, Kentucky bluebird. Fly away, Kentucky bluebird. Fly away, fly away.
Kelly Hupp.
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
Every once in a while, artists don't get it right. Dionne Warwick famously did not want to do Do You Know the Way to San Jose. She turned to Burton Hal and said, are you really going to expect me to sing Whoa, 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 Whoa? Well, it was one of her three or four biggest hits. I think she started to learn to like the song right around the time she cashed the first check. So here's another one. Tom Jones was called by his manager, Gordon Mills, and said, there's a new movie coming out, and Burt Bacharach and Hal David have written a song for it, and they want you to sing it. And it was What's New Pussycat? And Tom heard it, said, I don't want to do that. What is this about? This song is crazy. Yeah, I don't know what this is. I don't want to sing this. And Gordon said, you really need to sing this. This is going to be a big film. This is a good opportunity for you. And he said, I'm not so sure. And he's Bert made an appointment with him, and Bert came over and worked with him a little bit on it, trying to get him to like it. He still wasn't sure. But in the end, his manager pushed him on it, and he went ahead and did it. And I think it's fair to say it worked out pretty well for him. What's new, pussycat? Whoa, whoa, whoa. What's new, pussycat? Whoa. Pussycat, pussycat, I've got flowers and lots of hours to spend with you. So go and powder your cute little pussycat nose. Pussycat, pussycat, I love you. Yes, I do. You and your pussycat nose. What's new, pussycat? Whoa, whoa, whoa. What's new, pussycat? Whoa, 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 whoa. Pussycat, pussycat, you're so thrilling and I'm so willing to care for you. So go and make up your big little pussycat eyes. Pussycat, pussycat, I love you. Yes, I do. You and your pussycat eyes. Watch you, pussycat. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Watch you, pussycat. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Pussycat, pussycat, you're delicious, and if my wishes can all come true, I'll soon be kissing your sweet little pussycat lips. Pussycat, pussycat, I love you. Yes, I do. You and your pussycat lips. You and your pussycat eyes. You and your pussycat nose. I wasn't going to do this next one, but I think Richard Bernard is in the audience and his wife, Jane, is crazy about this song. So, and we have one spot to fill. So I'm going to take a stab at it. I haven't done this in a while. When Liberty Valance rode to town, the women folk would hide, they'd hide. When Liberty Valance walked around, the men would step aside. 'Cause the point of a gun was the only law that Liberty understood when it came to shooting straight and fast. Well, he was mighty good. From out of the East, a stranger came, a law book in his hand, a man, the kind of a man the West would need to tame a troubled land. But the point of a gun was the only law that Liberty understood when it came to shooting straight and fast. Well, he was mighty good. Many a man would face his gun, and many a man would fall. The man who shot Liberty Valance, he shot Liberty Valance. He was the bravest of them all. The love of a girl can make a man stay on when he should go. Stay on, just trying to build a peaceful life where love is free to grow. But the point of a gun was the only law that Liberty understood when the final showdown came to pass. A law book was no good. Alone and afraid, she prayed that he'd return that fateful night. Oh, that night, when nothing she said could keep her man from going out to fight. From the moment a girl meets a peaceful guy, very first thing she learns, when two men go out to face each other, only one returns. Everyone heard two shots ring out. One shot made Liberty fall. The man who shot Liberty Valance, he shot Liberty Valance. He was the bravest of them all. The man who shot Liberty Valance, he shot Liberty Valance. He was the bravest of them all. And what movie was that from? And I warn you, this is a trick question. No movie.
No.
John Ford decided this movie is a Western. It doesn't need a pop song. In fact, he used the whole score from another movie on that. It's only about, I think, about 8 minutes of music in the whole score. So when you bought the record, which was Gene Pitney on Music Core Records, it said the man who shot, in parentheses, Liberty Valance, and underneath it said, inspired by the movie, the man who shot Liberty Valance. Not in the movie. Here's one that is in a movie. If you ask me to name my favorite Burt Bacharach and Hal David song, it's this one. If you ask me to name my favorite song of all time, it probably is this one. And I always, every show, refuse to let anybody else sing it. much to their chagrin, yes. What's it all about, Alfie? Is it just for the moment we live? What's it all about when you sort it out, Alfie? Are we meant to take more than we give? Or are we meant to be kind? And if only fools are kind, Alfie, then I guess it is wise to be cruel. And if life belongs only to the strong, Alfie, what will you land on an old golden rule? As sure as I believe there's a heaven above, Alfie, I know there's something much more, something even non-believers can believe in. I believe in love, Alfie. Without true love, we just exist, Alfie, until you find the love you've missed. You're nothing, Alfie. When you walk, let your heart lead the way. And you'll find love any day, Alfie. Thank you. Thank you, Hal David. Wonderful lyrics. Going to bring my two friends back on stage for our closing number. This is a song I think they said sat in a drawer for a number of years. They didn't think it was going to be a hit. And of course, when they put it out, Jackie DeShannon had a big hit with it. And I think the lyric is more timely now than ever, because if this was ever the case, it's now. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone.
Lord, we don't need another mountain. There are mountains and hillsides enough to climb. There are oceans and rivers enough to cross, enough to last till the end of time.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone.
Lord, we don't need another meadow. There are cornfields and wheat fields enough to buy. There are sunbeams and moonbeams enough to glow. Oh, listen, Lord, if you want to know.
Love,
yeah,
it's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love.
No, not just for some, but for everyone. No, not just for some, oh, but just for everyone. Gary Johns, our engineer. Claire Bloom, our wonderful hostess.
Thank you, guys. Thank you out there in TV land.
Thank you so much, everybody.
Really, I mean it. I do. Wow. Hey, are you still on?
Yeah.
Hey, you guys out there. Jay said this to me earlier. You know, we've just needed to be doing something like this for about, oh, I don't know, 8-9 months or so. Yeah, I'm just saying, right? And so this literally is the first time that I know I've even seen these good people in 9-10 months.
Really long time.
It's a good thing. It's a blessing. We're here and we're counting each other, man. And we're counting on each other. So let's do what we can do for 2021 and make a difference and still be here with each other some kind of way. We got to do this, man. We got to do this.
Here, here.
That's all. Thank you, everybody, for being there.
Thank you.
Love you.
Good night, all.
Good night, everybody. Woo.